Thomas P. Griessa, a federal judge whose far-reaching, environmentally based rulings helped kill the bitterly contested plan to build the Westway Superhighway in Manhattan along the Hudson River but cleared the way for a huge redevelopment of Times Square, died on Sunday at his home in Manhattan. He was 87. His death was confirmed by Edward A. Friedland, the court executive for the United States Court for the Southern District of New York in Manhattan, where Judge Griessa had worked for 4 decades. He did not give the cause. Among the many cases presided over by Judge Griessa, who was appointed by President Richard M. Nixon, were two of the most ambitious development proposals in the history of New York City. The Westway Plan, adjudicated in the 1970s and 80s, presented one of the fiercest clashes between environmental and development forces the city had ever seen. The Times Square redevelopment proposed to transform one of the most storied, it tattered, urban districts in the United States. Westway was to run from the Battery, at the tip of Manhattan, to 42nd Street, replacing the West Side Highway, whose dilapidated state was underscored when a truck fell through an elevated section. With about half the road running through a tunnel, the projected cost was $2 billion, about $5.7 billion in today's money, and the federal government was to foot 90% of the bill. Environmental groups as well as mass transit and other civic organizations mobilized to stop the road from being built. In lawsuits, they contended that Westway would be a harmful boondoggle for highway and construction interests. The tunneled portion was to be built through new landfill topped by parkland and commercial development. The lawsuits asserted that Westway traffic would increase air pollution and harm the Hudson's fish, disputing a federal finding that the landfill would not significantly affect marine life. They further said that there had not been a thorough examination of an option to trade in the earmarked federal funds for a less expensive road combined with projects to improve mass transit. Westway's supporters, including the federal, state and local governments, said that the highway would actually help curb pollution by relieving traffic congestion, and that the fish study had been sound. The project would create jobs and needed waterfront parkland, they said, whereas trade-in benefits were uncertain. In 1981, Judge Griessa, pronounced Grisé, dismissed all the plaintiffs' objections except the one involving the fish study, which he said required a further hearing. After that hearing's conclusion, he ruled in July 1982, using unusually strong language, that federal and state agencies had colluded to mask key data about the potential harmful impact of the proposed landfill area on the Hudson's striped bass, which he noted was one of the nation's most popular and commercially lucrative fish. He then barred the use of all federal money for Westway, effectively blocking it. After a further study, completed in 1984, also forecast only minor harm to the striped bass, Judge Griessa refused to reverse his earlier ruling, saying that this study, too, had been deficient. He called an explanation of how its conclusion was reached sheer fiction.